What's up, y'all? It's Dream Key, and you're tuning in to Vision Vocal. Yeah, my name's Dream Key. I'm a recording artist out of Chicago, Illinois, actually in the suburbs in Wheaton. I'm just out here trying to push my sound, you know. I've been recording for about 2 years or something, and, you know, shit's really about to take off, you know, so... I can feel the slowness to your... You know, I actually grew up overseas in Indonesia, so when I was 2 to 8 or 2 to 10, I actually grew up in Indonesia, so most of my life I didn't really hear a bunch of like rap music. It was more like what main, like the mainstream, you know, pop music that would make its way over there. When I got back, I started hearing stuff like, what was it, Yeah by Lil Jon and Usher, I think that's what it's called. That was like really the first thing I heard that was like, you know, this shit's like different, you feel? I had that on replay for like 10 times, 20 times, like the iPod Nanos and shit. So that's really like when I first started hearing music in the way like I felt like I wanted to record, you know.
What about like when you were in high school and stuff, what was kind of played around that?
I play like Kid Ink, Wiz Khalifa, Tyga. Later in high school it was more like Lil Uzi, like Yachty and them, Kodak, you know, like most of those people. A lot of Machine Gun Kelly too. I mean, I like underground stuff too, but I didn't really get more into that until like I started making music and like, you know, listening to other people besides the mainstream. It wasn't like always mainstream, but you know, it was more like radio. And then like I figured out there's like hot new hip hop where you could just find like the newest tracks that are being posted. So it was really like I was listening to every new track that was coming out, you know, like trying to see what's up with that. This is the last time I let you play me. Taking it seriously, I really started like 2 years ago, but I've been writing since like 8th grade on and off. The first song, yeah, it's still out. I'm not gonna tell y'all where to find it because it's just not.
Can you play it for us?
Oh, you wanna hear the first? Yeah, I'll play it for you. It was actually over a Soulja Boy beat. This is the first thing I recorded. I'm over that crank that. Sniff a white like a bloodhound. If a nigga keep running his mouth, then I promise to enter the body count. Catch you lagging out. I can't. The bars were always there. The bars were there, but I mean, they're supportive of me in whatever I do. It's not really the norm to like go like want to make music, you know. So obviously, there's always that sense of doubt. But you know, I feel like things are picked up and like they see the progress and like what's on its way. So you know, I feel like they're becoming a lot more respective of it. So like that's like the best part about it, like seeing the people that like didn't think or like, you know, like didn't, yeah.
Do you have anybody else in your family that has followed a more creative career path?
My sister actually makes music. She's in a band. They actually make music. Yeah, they're pretty dope. I ain't never smiled in too many of my pictures, like throwing the top. You know, I work with my buddies, JJ West, Jay, Young Jay, my boy Fazo, you know, AB, Grills, 16th, you know, those are my brothers, you feel, so, you know, we're out here. Annika, you know, she right there, she make music too, you know, that's how I met all of them, actually, so I say those are pretty much like the main people that, you know, I'm really rocking with. My boy Chris, Heisey got the juice. Don't forget my boy Heisey got the juice. You gotta tag that right there. Yeah, so like that's really my group, you know, like.
How did you guys all meet each other?
It was actually at Annika's release party for Basement Songs. You know, my boy Spencer, he mixed a bunch of my stuff before I met like JJ and them. So Annika went through and, you know, got her stuff mixed by him and then brought us to the album release party, and that's where I met up with JJ. And it was JJ 6 and Jay. The rest is history, like it's just brotherhood after that, I guess. I mean, everyone in the group makes music, you know, like we're all artists. My boy James is actually pretty cold on the mix too. You know, he throws the mix on a lot of basically everything that comes through there. So, you know, and he's his own artist as well. So we're the wave, you feel like. I'm not trying to be on no arrogant stuff, but you know, there's a lot of stuff on its way right now. So like, y'all need to stay tuned for that. Oh my God. I mean, there's this one time, you know, we're recording at like 3 a.m. and like, you know, TikTok was just like, it's like really popping now, but this is like, I mean, this is like when it was like popping still, but like my friend Jay, like just out of nowhere, all of a sudden we hear like the lawnmower going off at like 3 a.m. and he's out here making a TikTok, just mowing the lawn. Like, we could like tag his fucking TikTok or something, but you know, he's just mowing the lawn at 3 a.m. So like, we're recording this like, bro, what the hell are you doing type shit.
Oh, this dude didn't even cut the backyard. What the hell?
Hey, yo ass ain't even cut the backyard.
Well, I'll be fucking there now. I guess I'll go do it then. What the hell? 3 a.m, we'll do it.
Well, I guess we gonna do it. That's how we do it around here.
What the fuck? I mean, like, usually I'm just doing like some punch-ins or just like some freestyles. If I'm really like writing something like a story, or like I want to get like real like emotional with it, like I'll write something, you feel, because like I just freestyle a lot of my stuff and like punch it in. But like when I'm writing like them stories, like I really like to, you know, write it down. I'll try and like make a song, but like if it's not there, I don't like how it sounds, I'll just like scrap it. I mean, like here and there I get like, you know, like writer's block and stuff like that, but like I feel like it's just about like experiences, you feel like the more you go out and do something, like the more you have to talk about it. We ain't never gonna be the same, and that's the sad part of life. I mean, you know, usually just through like Instagram and like word of mouth, I'll get like put in a group chat or something, and it's like, oh yo, what's up, like let's like make something, or like that's usually how I go about it. I don't know, like I'm open to doing like features with anybody really. Like,
have you ever felt like you've done that and it's gone wrong?
Most definitely, bro. I don't want like say anything, but like yeah, it's multiple times, you know, and like sometimes someone might send something that's like not it, and it's like, but like I'm always straight up, like it's not like it's like, oh, this ain't it, I don't want to work with you. It's like, yo, this might not be the vibe, like let's like try something else or something, you know. Like sometimes like they take it to offense, but like I'm not trying to mean like that, you know. Long-term goals, financial freedom off doing something that I love, being able to like give back to the ones who gave to me. Short-term, really just get my sound out there, because I know I have like the product for it. I just gotta get the sound out, and I feel like right now it's really just about like pushing my stuff out there instead of like holding on to it.
Do you feel like
so,
that ever puts pressure on you to like constantly release stuff, like you feel like you don't really have time to actually work on a really good song?
Yeah, sometimes it's more like I don't really feel like pressure to. Sometimes I get in my head, because like I make a lot of stuff and hold on to it, and then it's like, oh, this doesn't sound as good as like the new stuff, but like maybe it's because I've heard it like 100 times, but like it's still be new to someone else. Like that's like where I think I find like the most precious, like what to put out. I'll give it at least a week, you know, and if it's like still hitting like it did that first time, like then it's like, oh, like this one is it, you feel, like I'll put this out. And like it's all about timing too. Like I feel like I don't want to put like bangers out during December when it's cold. Like you want to put like some like a banger out when it's like hot, you feel, or like people can be outside and stuff, you know, like stuff's going on right now. But like throwing the towel, they keep saying I'm that nigga, I'm just trying to figure out. Yeah, I feel like getting out and like doing shows and stuff like that, you know, like that shit does take a toll, because like you can't get out in front of the people. But like at the same time, I got to like be in the studio, you know, like every day. I was like putting in a lot of work on that shit, you know. Currently I'm working on like, I don't know, finding like what fits me and like, you know, what type of stuff I could put out and like how I can group it together in like a project, maybe like a story or like, you know, like I could play something. Bro, I got ideas, you feel like. I'm probably gonna put out like some EPs, but I got like a mixtape idea on the way. I don't know, it's just gonna be like, I don't know how to explain it yet, but like, it's gonna be like a half and half project, you feel? And like, yeah, that shit, I think that shit, like, it's gonna do numbers or like, you know, like really make a statement. I think like, my proudest moment so far was like, when I put out my first project, Planet Key, because like it was like my first thing I put out, and like I would consider the stuff I have like now better, but like when the final song was done, everything was posted, and it was like the first play on the song, you feel like, when I heard Internal Bleeding, like I was like, yeah, like I did that, you feel like, I was proud. I was like, damn, like that shit is dope, you feel? I don't know, I just feel like it was a really good project, you feel, first project, so like that was like different.
Name three artists that you would like to be
compared to. Compared to? I don't know if I wanna be compared to nobody. I'm trying to like find my own name, but like I'd be like accompanied or something like that. I'd say like Trippie Redd, you know, like Juice WRLD, like and Lil Skies probably. Like those are probably like my three of my favorite artists. Getting Hurt, yeah. Cause I feel like I have the product, you feel like I said, but like getting my stuff out there is difficult, you know? Like, cause there's a bunch of other people doing it. And like, even if they don't have the sound, some of these people still have the money to like flood their stuff throughout social media, and it's like, oh well, how do I compete with that? I just gotta like get my own money and feel, you know, like, so like that's really finding the right places to put my stuff too, because I don't want to like put it on like fake streams or nothing like that. Like, I'm trying to like build something, like build a real like legacy and stuff, you know,
like trying to make a genuine fan base instead of just paying to have all your stuff everywhere, but it's not really like genuine, yeah, fans, I guess.
Because like, bro, like I'm sure everyone in this room like has someone they listen to that's like, damn, like I feel that way too, you know, like, and it's like, oh, that helped me through like whatever this. If I could be like that for someone else, you feel like that'd be dope, you feel?
Are you doing like all of your marketing by yourself, or do you have like people who help you out with that?
I mean, like really back to like the group and everything, like we all just like support each other, and you know, we ran into other people, like outside people, like my boy MK, he a producer, but like he putting on like he putting his stuff on my stuff on his story, you know, like just like he's like, just like I'm gonna put his stuff on my story, like it's just connections, you feel? Like I'd rather have a genuine connection with someone than like just like, I don't know, with that, but
yeah,
like,
no, it, like knowing the right people is really important when it comes to getting your stuff heard.
Get someone who can mix your shit. Get someone who can mix your shit, because if you're not hearing it back the right way, you will not improve. Like, it's so hard to improve if you're not hearing it back the right way. So, like, get your stuff with someone who can mix. Like, invest in yourself. Spend that $200 to get your studio session, you know? You gotta invest in yourself, or else you keep going to, like, the wrong person, and it's like, yo, like, I'm not hearing it back right, you feel? That's my best piece of advice. For engineering, like I work with my boy JJ West and Beats, you know, like Young JB, Descent, I'm trying to think, Eli. But yeah, it was really just like me, James in the studio, and then like all my, everyone else in the group, like pulled through and stuff. It was just like work in progress. It wasn't like I set out to like, yo, this is what I'm doing. I'm making this project, and then I'm gonna like do this song, this song, this song, this song. It was like over a period of time, you know, I was recording different songs. I was like, yo, like these go together, you know, and like tell the same story still. And then like I had to throw Swear to God on there because like that shit, everyone wants to hear the fucking, I like the hard hitting 808, so like, you know, I just do that on there at the end for like a, like I can still get on like that type of beat, you know.
Did you have features on there? I don't remember.
No. My Fag is like my first album, you know, or not album, but like first like project I put out, and like this is like to gain my following and like it fall on deaf ears. I feel like if I gain a following and then put someone on a feature, like that's gonna be a lot more beneficial than like, you know, like, oh, it's his first project, like first like thing, you know. I don't know, like I'm trying to gain something and then being able to like put somebody on, and it's like that the first time I put you on is the only time I have to put you on, you know.
Right. So with your next project, do you have features on there, or right now is it just all you?
Shit, I don't know. I honestly don't know. I have an idea. I also have an idea for like two or three more. So it's like which one? Like I haven't made the songs for like some of this stuff yet, you know. So I don't know. It's kind of a work in progress, but like I guarantee the next tape will be a lot better. Like something different. I ain't never smiled in too many of my pictures. Might throw in the towel, they keep internal bleeding. I don't know, it's just like just real, you feel like just like straight facts and that shit, but like it's like something everyone can relate to, you know, like heartbreak, someone leaving them, like that type of stuff.
Have you ever like released a song thinking that it was gonna blow up or like be a hit and then it actually doesn't do well?
Not as of recent, but like when I was like in between like studios, I recorded this song off like Logic at my house, and I thought it was like the one, you know, like I really thought it's the one. Like I sat there in the car like, oh my god, like gotta put this out, and then I put it out and like it was not it. Like I don't know, I took it down though. It was called Horoscope. I really thought it was the one though.
What like made you think like, oh, like this one's fine, like this one's like solid?
Dude, I don't know.
No, I wasn't saying like a bad thing. I'm saying like,
no, I know, bro. Dude, like, no, like,
no,
like, dude, really, like, I don't know, like, cause I've listened to it back and it's just like, this is not it. Like, I'm even thinking like, what the hell was I thinking? You know, like. This is the last time I let you play. Shit, you know, like Dragon Ball Z, like the Ki Blast, and then I just like dream of being like on like a different level, you feel, like being able to like change lives but like change mine at the same time, you know, like so it's just like maybe almost even like a statement, like I'm Ki and like someone's like Dream Ki, you feel, like Dream, like, you know, they're doing like the older movies and like I don't know, I'd say it's just like a statement. Keep dreaming, you feel like, cause you finna achieve something, you know, like keep following your dreams cause you wanna achieve something different. Like big stuff can happen, you know, I feel like big stuff something. I don't know, there's a lot of people in the studio, which isn't always fun, but like, I don't know, I feel like it was a good song, you know, like that shit, I feel like, it's different for me at least. Like I don't know if you're usually hopping on like rock stuff, but like it's different for me and Phil, and like I really liked how it came out, so it's like that's something I'd be down to like do again, you feel, like get on the rock beat. So
you guys should do like a collab project for like all
I told her that I told her that
in. How did the idea of making that song even come up?
Yeah, it's kind of just like I don't know, I feel like we're just like looking through beats and stuff, and like I don't know if we're looking for like a minute, but like I was, did you look up or like Paramore type beat? This shit was hard. I'm gonna deliver cause my pocket's low as fuck, man. I can't even get a swisher. Flipping burgers or something. I don't know, going to school or like playing, I used to play soccer, so like playing soccer or some shit. Like, I don't know. I can't imagine it, you feel like, without it.
What are your interests besides baseball?
I like to play video games. I like to play soccer, too. I don't know. I don't really have that many hobbies. Just make music and hang out the bros. Like, I don't know.
Like a favorite bar.
Favorite bar of mine?
Yeah.
My favorite bar of all time. Oh, okay. I said I just made this song like yesterday, 2 days ago. I'll play it. But I said, been focused, thought you noticed. My psychosis is a nuisance. Gun on both hips, osmosis. I'm with them like a pussum. And I said, need froze wrist on both. Needs froze shit on both wrists. Like coke heads, how the jewels both. And I was like, that rhyme scheme, like, no, you feel like fire. That's fire, you know, like, that's some different. It's like, you know, I was like out of my element on that beat. So it was like, yo, like, this shit is like different.
Can you tell us a fun fact about yourself?
I could speak a little Indonesian. I only know how to say like one or two things. Mau makan kotoran.
What does it mean?
Put that on the song. You just said it. No, it means, do you
want to
eat shit?
Oh my god.
That's about it.
Show us your favorite dance move.
Oh, I don't got no dance moves.
It's the TikTok.
Y'all seen that?
Oh shit, what is it?
Thanks for watching this interview. You can catch me at DreamKey_ on Instagram, DreamKey on all my other socials, SoundCloud, Spotify, Apple Music. So go check out my new song, Game Plan, I just dropped a new song. So Crash, you know, check out my collab with Annika, Hell to Pay, that shit fire, yeah. Deliver, cause my pocket's low as fuck, man. I can't even get a swisher.